Namaste students, myself Sunil Kumar from the Department of Computer Science. Today we are continuing our third session based on the chapter 9 constructors and destructors. Today's our topic is copy constructors, constructor overloading and destructors. In the last session we discussed about the types of constructor, mainly construct. What is a constructor means? Constructor is a special member function of the class that is used to initialize the object data, and it is invoked at the time of object creation. And the constructors mainly are of three types: one is a default constructor, parameterized constructor, and copy constructor. We studied about default constructor. The constructor does not contain any arguments. That type of constructors are known as default constructor. A constructor that takes one or more argument is called parameterized constructor. So whenever constructor takes one or more argument, whenever arguments are present in case of constructors, that is known as parameterized constructors or arguments. Parameter means arguments, parameterized constructors. And if you take the parameterized constructor, constructor can be invoked through following method. There are different methods are there. One is implicit call, explicit call, and using the assignment operator. Implicit call means along with the object creation we have to pass the values. In case of explicit, first we have to declare the object, then assignment operator equals, then class name, then how to pass the arguments. Then finally we can use one more method, that is assignment operator. So when you are going to declare the object, at that time use the assignment operator or equals, that is assignment operator, then you can pass the directly, you can pass the value. But if you use the assignment operator, only one value can be passed. It's not possible to pass multiple values. Only one values can be passed if we use the assignment operator. This much we discussed in the previous sessions. Today we are going to discuss about copy constructors. Copy constructor is a parameterized constructor. Copy constructor is also the parameterized constructor. Using this one, we can copy the one object data to another object. If you want to copy the one object data to another object of the same class, if you want to copy the one object data into another object of the same class, then we can use the copy constructors. Copy constructor can be used in following situations: to initialize an object with the values already existing object. So if you want to initialize an object, that set is already defined in another object, at that time we can use copy constructor. An object must be returned function as function values. Whenever if you want to return the object, should be written as a function values. Function will return the values like that object want to return means, then we can use the copy constructor to state object as by pass by value parameter of a function. So if you use the functions, we can pass by value, we can use. So if you want to use like that, then we can use the copy constructors. Copy constructor can accept single argument of a reference. Remember, copy constructor can take as a single argument of reference type of same class. Copy constructor will take only one argument. Parameterized means you can take multiple arguments, one or two is more than one is possible. But if you take the copy constructor can take only one argument. Remember, it will take only one argument, that is also in the reference or pass by reference, not pass by value. It should be in the form of pass by reference, but the argument should be a class type or object. In parameterized, you can pass the integer data or float, void, any other data you can pass. But in case of copy constructor, you will take only single argument. That single argument should be in reference format or reference argument address. Then it should be of object type or class type. Then here is a syntax for the copy constructor. So here class name is the name of the class, and should be declared in public section. So return type is not there. You can see in public section, class name is a constructor name, copy constructor name. Then inside the bracket, you can insert the, not bracket, it is a parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis, you can see class name space AND symbol, ampersand AND symbol, PTR. It is a one object. So we are creating the same class object. Remember, we are creating same class object inside the function or constructor. That is a reference of class type. Reference means ampersand symbol is used. Argument is class type. Class type means object. Remember that. Whenever if you are going to create the copy constructor should contain the argument of reference type of same class. Here same class object should be declared. Here is an example, class number. If you take the class number example in public section, one constructor is declared, that is a parameterized constructor. First one is the parameterized constructor with only one argument, number int n. So that is a normal parameterized constructor. So I assigned a is equal to n. Okay, that is assigned as a is equal to n. Then next one more constructor is created, number open bracket open parenthesis number of ampersand x, number ampersand x, that is actually known as copy constructor. See the first constructor and second constructor. In first constructor, that is parameterized constructor, argument is only one argument is there, but that is passed by value method and it is an integer type. Argument is integer type. And second, in number of ampersand x means it is a copy constructor. That copy constructor take the argument in the form of object or class type and should be in reference format. So we are passing the object x. X is passed. So a is equal to x dot a. X dot a means in which data is there in x, that is going to copy to a. In x dot a, which data is there, that is going to copy to a. This is syntax and example for copy constructors. And copy constructor is not invoked explicitly. It is not possible to invoke explicitly. You should call implicitly by using the class name. Is not possible to call copy constructor. That is possible only in parameterized constructor, not in copy constructors. Copy constructors are invoked automatically when a new object is created and equated to an already existing object in the declaration statement itself. Means first you create one object, default constructor. See the example. By reading that you cannot understand. See the example here. First I create, x is the class name, and I created object a1. That is first statement. When object is created, first we will create object. This is a default constructor, to invoke default constructor. Next statement is a copy constructor invoking. Whenever class is created with the new object x a2, new object is created, that is equated is a1. So a1 data is going to copy to a2. Which data is there in a1 object, that is going to copy to a2. That is actually the copy constructor. See, in statement is given that copy constructors are invoked automatically, means there is no need to call separately. When new object is created, new object is a2 here. New object is created and equated to an already existing object. So already existing object is a1. You have to give a2 is equal to a1, means which data is there in a1, that is going to copy to a2 and should be given in declaration statement. When you are going to declare the new object, this should be given. So here in this example, a1 is the default constructor, a2 that statement is copy constructor, invoking the copy constructor automatically. A2 is equal to a1 means which data is there in a1, that is going to copy to a2. When a new object is declared and existing object is passed as a parameter to it in the declaration, then also copy construct invoked. Is a one more method is there. First we can use the assignment operator and we can call that one. And second example, second method, first you have to give one parameterized constructor. Not only parameterized constructor, you can declare default constructor also. So I declared is x a1 of 100, 200, means that is a parameterized constructor. I declare one object with the parameterized constructor, two values I pass, one is 100 and 200. That is for object a1. Next statement, is a one more method of invoking copy constructor. X A2 of A1 not equals is also possible. A2 equals A1, that also possible. Or one more method, X A2 of A1 means it is like a calling functions, like a calling functions. Object is a function, A1 is an argument. I'm calling the function A2, but argument is A1. So that is also possible. So one more method in case of copy constructor. When object is passed to a function using pass by value, copy constructor automatically called. Here I passed one pass by value, object is passed for a function, or for a constructor I passed one argument, that is object type. Copy constructor is invoked when object returns a value. So it will invoke when, if you want to return a value, object returns when object is going to return the value, at that time it is going to invoke. Next topic, constructor overloading. A class has two or more constructor functions with the same name but different signatures is called as constructor overloading. So just to understand, in case of C++, it is possible to declare multiple constructors for the same class. If you are going to declare multiple constructor for the same class, then all the constructor will have the same name, because that is a feature of the constructor. Constructor should name should be same as class name. So all the constructor will have the same name, but signature means arguments. Signature here means argument. Argument may differ. So I created two constructor, one is a default constructor, one parameter constructor. So that argument is differs, argument or type of the argument is differ. So if you create multiple constructor for the same class, then it is known as constructor overloading. Depending upon the type of the argument, the constructor will be invoked automatically by the compiler to initialize the object. Based on the number of argument, constructor will invoked automatically. If you create multiple constructors, constructor will be invoked automatically in a program based on the number of and type of the argument. Here is one example, programming example. Class simple interest. Simple interest is a program in that two constructor declared. One is simple interest, default constructor. Nothing I initialized. I just created one example. For example purpose, I created one constructor. Simple interest is a constructor. Then that is a default constructor. Next, one more constructor is declared. Simple interest, float x, float y and float z. So that is a parameterized constructor with the three arguments. See, the two constructors created for a same class, simple interest. One is default constructor. One more is parameterized constructor with the three arguments. So here one more function I created to compute the data. That will be. Then we will move to the void main. In void main, I declared two objects, S1 and S2. So S1 object, that automatically called the default constructor, because I have not passed any data. So it will automatically invoke the default constructor. And one more object is created, S2. S2 object, I passed three data. One is 10,000, then 10,000.0, 12.0 and 2.0, because it will pass in default in parameterized constructor. I use the floating point, so I use the 0.0 or point floating point values. So when you are going to declare the object like this, S1 will invoke simple interest default constructor, S2 will invoke the parameterized constructor based on the number of argument. Whenever if you are going to create two is required. So whenever here three arguments are required, so three argument passed, so automatically it will match the constructor types. That is actually the constructor overloading. Next, we will move to the last topic of the constructor and destructor chapter, destructors. Destructor is a special member function that is executed when an object of that class is destroyed. So if you want to create the if you want to deallocate the memory, or if you want to destroy the data allocated, data is given by using the constructor. You can initialize the data by using the constructor. If you want to destroy the data initialized by the constructors, then we can use the special member function destructors. Destroying an object means reallocating all the resources such as memory that was allocated for the object by the constructor. So here it will destroy the object. Normally we will say it is a destroying the object. Destroying the object means deallocating the resources. Remember, the two words are there in computer. One is allocating the memory, one more is deallocating the memory. Allocating the memory means it is a reserving the some memory for the particular variable. Reserving the some memory reservation we are doing, that is allocating. And deallocating means after work done, after finishing your work, computer, that memory should be released, or because we have to use the same memory for some other operations. For example, 2 GB RAM is there, means so in this 2 GB, 1 GB is used, so we are not releasing that 1 GB, that 1 GB will be wasted. So we don't want to waste the memory, so we have to deallocate the memory after your program. Then good programmer will do the deallocating of the memory. So if you want to deallocate the memory or resources, then destructors are used. So destroying the object means deallocating all the resources such as memory that was allocated for the object by the constructor. So when you are going to allocate the memory, when you use the constructor that is used for allocating the memory, that allocated memory is destroyed, that is deallocating by using the destructors. It will have like constructor. The destructor will have same as constructor. The name of the destructor is same as class name. So constructor and destructor name will be same because it uses same as class name, but one of operator is we are using as a prefix, that is tilde operator. You can see like a wave operator, an operator is there, so that we are using in case of destructors. That operator is known as tilde operator. Here is a general syntax and a small example. Class, class name. Class name is the name of the class. So first I declared class name with the one constructor. Constructor is declared with the one argument, without argument, default constructor I declare. And next line you can see tilde operator or wave sign operator. That operator, that operator name is tilde operator. Then class name, the name of the class should be given for constructor and destructor. This constructor name and destructor name should be a same. You can give the same, it should be same name. There is no argument in case of destructor, so should be empty. And here is example, class counter. Counter is a class name and I declared one constructor. Then counter of open bracket, then I declared one constructor, n is equal to 0. And when you are going to destruct that one, tilde operator, class name, open bracket, closing bracket, open parenthesis, closing parenthesis, then open flower bracket and closing flower bracket. So that is a destructors. Then some features of the destructor, characteristics of destructor. The destructor name must have the same name as the class name preceded by a tilde operator. So destructor name should be same as class name. Constructor name also should be same as class name. Destructor name also should be same as class name, and but it should be preceded by tilde operator. We have to use prefix, like tilde operator we have to use prefix. Then the destructor cannot take argument, therefore cannot be overloaded. Remember, the constructor can take one or more argument. Constructor will have one or more argument, but in case of destructor there is no argument. Arguments are not possible in case of destructor, so it's not possible to overload. So multiple destructor is not possible because there is no argument. The destructor has no return type, as same as constructor. Constructor also does not have any return type. Destructor also does not contain any return type. And there can be only one destructor in each class. For if you are creating multiple constructor for a class, when you are going to create multiple constructor for a same class, then there is no need to create multiple destructor for a same class to destroy the data. Only one destructor is enough to destroy the all the objects. normally in a class, one person is enough to destroy everyone. Like that, in a class, one destructor is enough to destroy all the objects. There is no need to create the multiple destructors to destroy the data. It should have public access in the class declaration. Destructor should be declared in public section, and destructor cannot be inherited, not possible to inherit the destructors, and it is invoked at the end of the program. Remember, constructor is invoked at the when you are going to declare the object. When you are going to declare the object, constructor is invoked, but destructor is invoked at the end of the program. Next, we will see the programming example. In this programming example, class is created, num is the class name, and I created two functions, one function display and one constructor and destructor. So I extended the constructor outside and I also extended the destructor outside. That is also possible. If you want to extend the constructor outside, can extend outside. If you want a destructor, also is possible to write outside. So num, then scope resolution operator constructor, then I constructor as x is equal to 100. So it is value is assigned, default constructor. Then one more destructor. Destructor also I written. No need to write anything inside the destructor, but I wrote cf in destructor just to understand there is a destructor. Then display function is written. Then finally in void main, we went reach the void main. I created num a. So one object is created. When you are going to create the object, at that time it will invoke the constructor. Here I used the default constructor, so automatically it will invoke the default constructors. Then I called a dot display. A dot display, if I call, it will call the display function. What is written inside the display function, that will be executed. Then finally we will reach the end of the program. When you are going to reach the end of the program, there is no special call for destructors. There is no special call for destructor. Destructor will call automatically at the end of the program, because when you are going to finish the program, at that time which data we allocated, that should be released. So at the end of the program, destructor will call automatically. There is no need to call destructors. This is about destructors. So in this chapter we had three sessions. We discussed about the constructors, types of constructors, parameterized constructor, default constructor and copy constructor, constructor overloading, then destructors. So we'll wind up our today's session. Thank you.